Hi you guys. So I'm getting ready to start my day. It is beautiful out, but it's cold. It actually is cold outside, so I'm getting ready to. In my room, Rodney. In the closet. I'm getting ready to start the day of getting my car washed and getting Antoine all together. And getting Lorenzo's hair done. Say hi, Lorenzo.
Hey. It's gonna be the same thing as my mama's.
He's gonna have starting his locks is where we're going. And crazy. Anywho, so yeah, we're getting our day started and I had to end up spending almost $700 on the electric bill last night, so I'm a little slight irritated about that, but I will survive. Because I had asked my mother, the reason, let me tell y'all what happened. I asked my mom to call them and get the extension, and she never did that. So it was supposed to be paid by 5 o'clock yesterday, or we would have gotten disconnected. Needless to say, she forgot and was like, oh, you didn't give me the paperwork. Oh, you didn't give me the paperwork. So I didn't get off work until 7 o'clock last night. So I had to end up rushing and paying this so that it wouldn't be no mistakes and them cutting off my daggone electricity and me waking up this morning in the dark or something. Not to say they would have cut it off during the weekend, but I just don't like taking no chances like that. And I don't like my crap getting cut off by any means. You know, I don't got time to play them games. So anyway, I was slightly perturbed by that because I really didn't want to start dipping into big money as of yet, at least until I started paying off my Jamaica trip. So it is what it is.
So I am going to this one place over here that I know. I'm gonna see if they can squeeze him in to get his hair done. If she tells me, yeah, we can take him and we'll lock his hair up, I'll, you know, leave him there and then come and get the car wash. So I'm gonna try to kill two birds with one stone. Quality type of camera. So, you know, whatever y'all can suggest or
If I look at all of you guys' vlogs, all of the vlogs of my followers that I'm following, and I'm seeing very good quality. Like, this is my phone right now that I'm using, and I would say it has good quality, but it's not, like I said, it's like I can't do a lot of things with it. I can't do a lot of editing. I can't do, you know, and that's why I said I would like to get the laptop and the camera together. But my funds are not like that, you know what I'm saying? I'm still a mom at the end of the day, and I still have responsibilities that I have to take care of. So, you know, trying to flex and do all of this extra, you know, that's not about. That's not what I'm about. I still gotta do something with my kids. So, so I'm trying to think, you know, trying to think what's the best thing to do. That's what I'm kind of stuck on right now, but. Hey, we'll figure it out. I'll figure it out one way or the other. So, anywho, so we're going phone shopping today too. That's another thing that we're doing for. We're trying to find a family plan. And a lot of people have been telling me which companies to go to and which companies not to go to. So I'm gonna let everybody know my personal views on certain things. Like, for me, I am one who is for cheap and cheerful at all times. Cheap, cheerful, and good service. Good quality service. But you, me being a mom, I feel like my phone should work wherever I go. I mean, I understand there's dead spots that they're gonna have around the United States when you travel and stuff like that. What?
Are you gonna be making videos where I play flag?
Yes, I am. Sit back in your seatbelt. Thank you. But when I travel and stuff, you know, I understand there's gonna be dead spots, but it's just like, you know, you say to yourself, okay, this dead spot, but it should, my service should still work. So I want good service, but then I also want something that I can afford. I'm not trying to break myself paying a car note just for good service on a cell phone. You feel me? And for all my kids at that. And I always want to know where my sons are at all times. For my 9-year-old, you know, we get the, being that he get, you know, they receive benefits or whatever. They get the free government phone. So he has that phone. And so he has that, and I know I can call him on that phone. But for Rodney, being that he's 13, getting ready to turn 14, oh my God, it just sounds so, whew, I get quivers, I get goosebumps just saying it, guys. It's crazy. I can't believe my baby is turning 14. April 14th is really going to be a emotional day for me because my baby is turning 14. I'm going to be crying and everything. I asked him what did he want to do for his birthday. He said to me, he goes, what did you say you wanted to do?
I think I said.
You said you wanted to do something mellow, like dinner or something. He was like, I do want to go to dinner with everybody. It's like a restaurant.
Yeah, thanks.
Football camp or soccer camp. You're talking about no camp there. What are you talking about? Oh, over there in the fields. Oh, okay.
Football camp.
They're probably practicing. Oh, okay, that's nice. Don't you wish that was your ride? No.
Maybe at a different field, yes, but
you, that's your school. You about to leave the journey of Brooklyn. You trying to hurry up and go to high school?
Yeah.
Why? Oh Lord, child, relax. Relax, relax, relax. Slow down. Anyway, so back to what I was saying. April 14th is going to be a very emotional day for me. So he did say he wanted to have dinner. He wants, so it's not, so that lets me know, I'm getting all choked up now, but it lets me know that he wants to, he's starting to more mature. And he said dinner, and I think he wants family there or something. And I don't know what the other thing was, but I'm sure it's going to come about when once we get closer to his day. So anyway, I'm taking that day off, of course. I mean, I'm thinking, is it a Saturday? I may not have to take off, but whatever. So what else? It is 12 o'clock now, and oh, so anyway, what was I saying? Yes, I want to get this family plan. I almost lost train of my thought. This family plan, and I'm thinking of going with Sprint, and I've heard the goods and the bads with Sprint. So the goods with Sprint is that their internet service is immaculate, and that's because I do see on there that they give you 150 megabits or specs or whatever the heck it is. So I understand that that's good, and it's unlimited. So that's great. You know, you're not sharing through the family plan or whatever. That's great. I love that. Okay. And from my understanding, the range of service is good as well. Okay. But what I also heard on the negative side of Sprint was that they have all these hidden charges and hidden fees, and that I'm gonna have to read my bill with a microscope, you know, just to make sure that I'm not being overcharged for stuff or stuff that I didn't even ask for, because Sprint supposedly works off of commission, so they just add all these added fees onto your account when you didn't even ask for none of this stuff. I will choke Sprint if you start trying to pull money out of me that I didn't ask for. You got me effed up. So, don't try it, because I don't have money to be paying for extra fees that I didn't ask for. So I will have to now start paying attention to my bill so that I'm not being overcharged for something, because I will go the fuck off. I'm so serious. I really try not to curse, but it just dawned on me that if I'm being overcharged for stuff, and I'm just like, I'm mad that people were telling me that type of review about Sprint, because, you know, I've never really looked at Sprint as a company to just throw fees on stuff. Like, no, that's not okay. So I will be paying attention to my bill like a microscope. Try me. I'm saying the wrong word. I'm saying microscope. I mean magnifying glass. Because let me find out I'm being overcharged for anything. We having an issue. I'm choking somebody. But anyway, yeah. So at the end of the day, I'm gonna go and find out. I turned too soon. I sure did. Or did I turn too soon? Yes, I did.
You should have turned to Alex's neighborhood. Old neighborhood.
Who?
You should have turned into Alex's old neighborhood.
So it's
ghetto.
Well, I turned too soon anyway, because I was really close to turn.
But Alex's old neighborhood has two old neighborhoods. That one and, like, that one.
Oh, yeah, she did used to live over here. Okay, I guess. But, yeah, so I'm hoping that Katie can twist my son's hair, started locking his hair up today, and give me a good price. And I know she would say to me, oh, you got to set the appointment. Oh my gosh, can I turn in here today? I'm hoping so. Hold on, I need to turn, people. Can I turn? Are you gonna let me turn or no?
Yes,
go. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Anywho, so it's really nice. I just wish it was warm, but I got my heat in my vehicle. But this is good and toasty in my car, because I clearly didn't put a coat on thinking it was summertime. Oh, yeah, so of course there's no parking. Every time I come over here, there's no parking. Every goddamn time. The last time I came over here, no parking. Oh my god. I It's never no parking over here. Every single time. I'm gonna park here for a second and you sit in the car. Okay.
Who gonna watch me?
Wait, no, why don't you just park in that little handicap space right there?
No, you cannot do that.
But why she parked in there?
I'm just gonna go in here and ask a quick question first. Right, let me go get out.
The phone with her, she just leaving up in here. I mean that's okay. Hello, hi, hello. I was gonna start, never mind.